Early carpets were made in Brussels, and they called them low-level loops. That's still a term used today. And this is before they started cutting them to get flush pile. And of course, they had small looms, and that's why they're only two-thirds of a yard. Peter Mead is an Englishman who's been over here for
25 years,
and this is his trade. Now, Peter, we just saw you basically bend them back, and you've already marked off the...
I've marked off the pattern where I want to sew the carpets together.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to come down to 3 points, and I'd put a locking stitch in, basically. Just so.
And it's a little bit like, this always reminds me of sailmakers and stuff, because the types of needles and I guess watching a man sew goods like this is so reminiscent of sails. What kind of thread is it that you have to
use?
This
is a waxed linen thread made in Alabama.
And these are Wilton carpets made in England.
Exactly.
And of course, any place that they're doing a high style house from the early 1800s here in America, you're apt to find fancy patterned Wilton carpets like this.
Exactly.
And then?
And then I sew the carpet together with about 1/4 inch stitch, maybe a little bit less.
What kind of a stitch is that? That's the basic stitch,
just
right?
Just the basic stitch, yeah. Over and over. And you just keep going until you reach the other.
You just keep rolling along. Okay. Early carpets were made in Brussels, and they called them low-level loops. That's still a term used today. And this is before they started cutting them to get